K98 Talk is expanding its lineup for 2015. This means we are expanding our advertising base. Whether you're a startup trying to push through to the next level, or an established business trying to supplement your advertising budget, web-based advertising is a solid investment. Thanks to Talk's newest partnership with TuneIn Radio and instant access to our sister station, K98 FM, we give you worldwide access at a reasonable cost. Interested parties should email us at sales@k98fm.com.
In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If your vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
Joe had huge problems with the IRS.
I knew it was coming. I hadn't filed taxes since 1990.
All the IRS letters coming in added up to a nightmare.
To get up to like $68,000, my heart started beating fast. It's like, there's no way, man. I mean, I ain't going to be able to do this.
Then they stopped his paycheck.
So that's when I started making phone calls and found U.S. Tax Shield.
U.S. Tax Shield went to work immediately.
They just took the bull by the horns. What blew my mind is he called the IRS right then and there.
So why is U.S. Tax Shield A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau? Joe knows.
They saved me a ridiculous amount of money.
If you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS or state, choose the company Joe chose, U.S. Tax Shield.
It was the best decision I made. U.S. Tax Shield is the way to go. Life is good. Thank you, Lord.
Call 800-471-3287.
U.S. Tax Shield. Boo-rah. Yes.
800-471-3287. 800-471-3287.
Game on with Progressives Fear Us and Rhinos Tremble. Welcome to the political jungle. I'm JD.
This is Stacey. No one is safe. No one is spared.
Lock up the children.
And the old folk.
Welcome to the world of libservative conservatarian.
Welcome to all our political freaks, geeks, and back alley sneaks. Tuesday night, October 13th, 2015, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. That means it's JD and Stacey. It's time for Game On that K98 Talk. Watching the debate, well, let me tell you, Stacey and I were watching the debate tonight. Anderson Cooper got to lay off that cocaine, baby, that devil's dandruff, that Bolivia marching powder. Asking them questions like, did you know what? Everybody right
he
now.
He was awfully snippy.
Snippy. We'll get to him in a
snippy.
Second. Everybody right now, because that was a snoozer. It's just for them losers. Get to that K98talk.org. Get in that chat room. Say hello to Stacey.
Hi.
Not just Stacey, but that best damn listening radio audience in the business. We got a very special treat for you tonight. We're going to be breaking down that North Korean hostage video moderated by Anderson Cooper out there in Las Vegas, baby. We got dildos and holsters. Boobies and much, much more. Let it sink in. And that's right, kids. We're not just here Tuesday night live, 10 p.m. We're also live again Thursday night, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for Game On. And Sunday's here again on that K98 Talk, 11 a.m. for that Bloody Marys and Broadsheets, baby. Your cure for that mainstream media hangover. We are also happy and proud to announce we have joined the WNJC 1360 AM, WNJC, up in that Southern Jersey, Philadelphia, and that Northern Delaware, baby. 7.4 million listeners every Friday at 5 o'clock. You can find Stacey and I there with all our shenanigans. JD going to be on that Flipside Show either this weekend or next weekend. You go to theflipsideshow.com, get to that channel, find a Stacey. If they don't carry it with the cable company, what happens?
You call the cable company and you say, we want the Flipside Show.
That's right, baby. And as always, you get over to that Spreaker.com, hashtag JD and Stacey, J-D-A-N-D-S-T-A-C-E-Y, and you find out everything we've been doing here for that Rig-a-Tiggy-Tavi, Rick Robinson on that K98 Dog, baby. Good evening, darling. How is you?
I'm good.
Oh,
I have
my.
One big question from the debate.
You just did one? What was that?
What happened to Hillary's lips? They're like gone.
What does she need them for? Monica was the one blowing Bill.
I'm just saying, I'm like watching her talk and it just, her lips have just disappeared.
And for all of you ladies in the audience, don't listen to me. It's more about tongue and throat.
Wow. That
okay,
is really
terrific.
Early in the show for the inappropriate.
Giggity, 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 let's have sex.
Did you not say make it a show or let's make it a show?
Wow.
And remember, for those of you who are new to JD and Stacey and Game On, always.
It's not going to be an orgy. It's a toga party.
Okay, so.
That was just for you, Tina.
Oh, my God. So here was Stacey and I, and you know, Rick is absolutely amazing. Between the partnership we have with 1360 WNJC and the K98 Talk News organization, we actually have clips. This debate is still going on. Here are two clips from Anderson Cooper. One is his introduction and one is an actual question to a candidate.
Three simple words. I am gay.
You ever seen a grown man naked?
So that's been... Has that basically summed up the last hour and a half? Well, he runs into the bathroom and goes...
let's rewind to 8:30, because this whole circus was going to kick off at 8:30, right?
Oh, my God.
Okay,
they didn't
so
even do the
roll back to 8:30. Okay? I turn it on, and I find myself listening to the dulcet tones of David Axelrod, which kind of makes you want to put a gun to your head.
Oh, my God.
Okay? Because there's no bias there at all.
They have to play his voice in seminary speakers to keep people from masturbating and having, like, sexual thoughts.
Oh, my God.
How'd you like to mow my lawn? Huh?
And then we had all the obligatory hand-wringing about whether another old white guy is going to get in the race. What is Biden going to do? And Biden better do it quick, because he's keeping us all in such suspense. Because that's going to change the composition of the field so much.
Something tells me whenever Biden does it, he does it quick. Jill does not look satisfied.
Okay, Biden. Terrific.
Anyway, and then Debbie Wasserman Schultz, that woman needs a flat iron.
Okay.
She blocked me on one Twitter account for suggesting it. And every time I see her, I just want to take a brush and straighten her hair.
Oh, man. You know what? Well, she has to share parents.
Who is your daddy and what does he do?
Before we get into Debbie Wasserman Schultz and the rest of the nonsense. I'm glad you brought up Uncle Joe. I'm glad you brought up Uncle Joe, because our audience is very politically savvy and plugged in. I know they've been watching this North Korean hostage video that's being broadcast live from the Wynn Hotel in Vegas.
No, we told them we'd do it for them.
Oh, this is, I mean, first of all, I for as much as we laugh about the 437,93,008, I've even forgotten, and a half jerk-offs on our side that are running for president. These people are not ready for prime time. The Republicans about to go into their third debate. And honestly, watching this, they honestly look like five people arguing with each other. The only scary thing is you get a Stepford wife insight into a Democratic primary or progressive primary voter. I mean, they were in there and, you know, we'll get into all this Black Lives Matter, all the guns, grabs and everything else. But back to what you were saying about Joe Biden. This debate is going to get such bad numbers, and nobody is going to be able to stick around through the whole thing, that they were trying their damnedest. Damnedest. People were basically begging Joe Biden. The Dems, Stacey and I agreed to this before the Joe. Before the show. The Democratic Party was basically, they wanted this to be like a WWF scene, and right before the debate started, they wanted Biden
that
to come out. They wanted Biden in the background like this. The lights are going down. Hillary's like, what's going on?
Uncle Bernie's like, is it the black people? Is it the colored people? Mr. Vargas, the colored people are yelling. What is this?
Just Joe Biden coming out like WWF wrestling style, baby. What's up, bitches? I'm here, son. What?
You know.
And then Jim Webb picks him up and smacks the podium.
The montage at the beginning, and if you are on social media at all and you do that horrid thing called Twitter moments.
Yeah, I still don't understand.
And you go, well, because that tells you what everybody's talking about. So earlier today, they had this picture of Hillary Clinton on one side and Bernie Sanders, and they're like facing off. And I'm like, all I could do was laugh. I mean, they're like trying to position these two relatively elderly people as like, you know, Apollo Creed and Rocky Balboa. I mean, it didn't work.
Oh,
it was
God.
Ridiculous. That montage at the beginning, I laughed so loud I scared my dog.
He farts dust, and she's going to be in a Little Rascal. So, kids, everybody admitted nobody thought Uncle Bernie would get this kind of run. So because he announced up in Vermont, and because Ben and Jerry were behind Uncle Bernie, very jokingly, this
because
has been...
Because you can have 150 flavors of ice cream, but not 23 kinds of deodorant.
Ugh, patchouli. So this has been affectionately Uncle Bernie's theme song on the show.
I put my vanilla Dixie cups on flavors and bullshit to under ice cream, man.
But I was watching that debate tonight, and I encourage all of you to watch it, because he actually is a cross between Christopher Lloyd playing the Reverend Jim on Taxi, but the way that Christopher Lloyd looked in the last Back to the Future movie. So they'd ask him a question, and he'd be like, I don't know, climate change, you know, and Danny DeVito would step out of things. So Uncle Bernie, just for you, a little bit more appropriate, I think. A little bit more appropriate for Uncle Bernie, because I think his speech is slowing down. This is going to be our new Uncle Bernie Sanders Feel the Burn theme song, baby.
Boom, boom, boom.
This is great.
It seems a lot more fitting.
Hold on, listen to the lyrics.
When I often call me Speedo, but my real name is Mister. No, for meeting brand new fellas and taking other folks' girls.
Here it comes, here's the one.
When I often call me Speedo, cause I don't believe in wasting time.
Oh, my God.
Wait a minute. No, oh, my God. No, you know who he reminds me of?
Who?
Remember the old man that Tim Conway used to play on the Carol Burnett show?
Oh,
who would
yeah.
shuffle up and get himself, you know, Mrs. Huey.
I was really excited when he came out on the stage, because every campaign you see from him, right? He's outside and the wind is blowing and that hair just goes everywhere. He came out on the debate stage and he had a coif, dude. It was all down, and he got so riled up during the debate that before I left, it was starting to stick up all over the place.
Be careful the way you say coif. You'll get us kicked off the terrestrial.
Okay, terrific.
I said coifed. Oh, you know what? You don't like the way I say any number of words.
But no, honestly, Uncle Bernie, he's Reverend.
I know what you were. You know what? I hung up on you before. I will do it again.
Oh, my God. There's nothing better. You know what that joke was? That joke was a time bomb joke.
I said it. You know what it was? No, you know what we'll call that? That was a Ron Popeil. I said it and forget it.
Good God. Oh, no. They just put the...
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Please. Where'd they win?
Oh.
Oh, my God. The midgets.
Now you're going to have JD talking about midgets. Thanks, Dex.
The midgets with the flying blade. No. Well, listen, once they put midgets in the chat room, it's...
It's over, Johnny. It's over. Nothing is over. Nothing. You just don't turn it off.
All right, so let's get back to this debate. There was a little intrigue before the debate. That Debbie Wasserweich-Schultz, who for some reason I am starting to believe she is the highest up Clinton ally that the Clintons have right now.
Oh, absolutely.
Because I don't think she's well-loved by the administration. She is not well-loved in her party because, you know, and this goes back to, and we hit this on the Sunday show, you know, for all the MSM is going to play about the Republican infighting, the infighting on the right, the Democratic Party is so fractured right now. Dem infighting erupts on eve of first presidential debate. Excuse me, this is from The Hill. Democrats are battling one another offstage ahead of the parties, this is tonight, with prominent lawmaker engaged in a fierce war of words with the party chairman Debbie Wasserweich-Schultz. Yeah, I know nothing. Rep. Tulsi Gabbard from Hawaii, a vice chairwoman of the Democratic National Committee. Ooh, now these are two chairwomen's babies, so there can't be no war on women here, is all but calling DNC chairwoman Debbie Wasserweich-Schultz a liar as the two publicly battle over whether Gabbard was disinvited from Tuesday night's debate. This is great. Gabbard stood by her claims in a string of interviews Monday night and Tuesday, arguing she was being punished for vocally criticizing her party for only holding six debates. Quote, "It's not surprising to me that she is saying things that aren't true," she said of her House colleague during an appearance on Tuesday's NBC with Andrea Mitchell. Wasserweich-Schultz, this woman is so in reality. So basically, this woman goes, "Hey, she kicked me out of the debate." Wasserweich-Schultz goes, "No, I didn't kick her out of the debate." Quote, "What we said was, as my staff communicated to her staff, is that she needed to focus on the issues and make a commitment to do that. And in fact, she said yesterday, da 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 da." Wasserweich-Schultz kicked this woman out, didn't she? And she's none too happy about it.
Of course she did. And now she's trying to gloss all over it and make it look better. And no. We just said, if that's going to be your attitude, don't come. I mean, that sounds like something I would say to my teenage daughter.
But let me
ask you, know, when you're going like on a family vacation and they've just gone off to college and they're kind of, you know what? If that's going to be your attitude, just don't come. You know?
Well, I think this goes back to making the connection that Wasserweich-Schultz is the closest ally that the Clintons have, because Gabbard is consistently described as an up and coming Democrat. You see her on a lot of the party puts her out as a spokesface for a lot of the issues on the shows. And she's actually vocally criticized the administration about the ISIS policy. I wonder if you don't see here people making moves saying maybe Hillary not so much.
Yeah, I mean, I honestly believe that if Biden does get into the race, Obama's going to be like, see ya, Hill. Debbie Wasserweich-Schultz has been running air cover for Hillary Clinton on this debate thing for months.
Well, of course she is.
O'Malley has been critical. Sanders has been critical. You know, now other folks in the party have been critical. And the big difference in one of the articles I read is the same number of debates were scheduled by the party last time, but there were also unsanctioned, if you will, events where the candidates met one another.
Right.
The party has now said,
yes, if you do one of those uncensored events,
you can't participate in the official ones.
Well, isn't that just democracy in action? I mean, isn't
absolutely.
That just, you know, look, these people are so good. You should never make the analogy. They really are. They're very Prussian. They're very Prussian circa the late 1930s. I mean, the way that they think tactically about elections is actually disgusting. At least you have on our side. I'm not putting anybody up on our side as saints, but at least you have people that are sitting there going, hey, wait a minute. There's some problems. There's some issues. How do we address them? And you want to know what? 45 seconds left, Stacey, before we go into break. We'll come back on the other side, break down a little bit what was said in the debate. But was it not striking to you about how prepared Republicans have to be to answer questions because of the way they are so used to being beaten like dogs by the media, that I just thought it was striking that these five couldn't answer questions really?
Yeah, I mean, it was actually, to me, what, and we'll get into it in the next segment. When the Republican debate started, it was question, 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 question.
Right, right, right.
Do your 10-second spiel, and then we're going to start asking questions. The pomp and circumstance around the first 30 minutes of this was like vomit-inducing.
Oh, let me tell you something. Don't forget, kids, Stacey's spiel is not to be confused with Glocken's spiel. Coming back at the other side of the break, we're going to break down some of this nonsense that was going on. Now we got another break before we can start talking about dildos and holsters and boobies flying everywhere, baby. JD and Stacey and that K98 talk. Fridays, 5 p.m., that WNJC 1360 a.m., baby. WNJC. The game on, the show getting so big, baby. Diamond Dave. Diamond Dave loves us. Ain't that right, Diamond Dave?
One break. Coming up.
Hey folks, Slickery Trigger here. I'd like to take a minute to tell you about Rebel Road Tactical. As a defensive pistol instructor, I've had the opportunity to observe many different holster designs and configurations. And one thing is clear, many of my students won't carry a pistol. Or worse, they'll carry one without a holster at all. Holster designers aren't making holsters for normal people. It seems that most holsters are either an expensive piece of gear designed for Rambo or a piece that doesn't fit or function the way real people need it to fit and function. So, like any good Texan, I decided to learn to form kydex and design one myself, one that would fit the needs of average people. The result is the Rebel Road Tactical CRT Modular. The CRT stands for Carry, Range, and Training. Its thin and lightweight curved design minimizes printing and is adjustable to fit just right for superior comfort and function. Check us out after the show at rebelroadconcealed.blogspot.com.
If you like your health care plan, you'll be able to keep your health care plan. This is the most transparent administration in history. Not even a smidgen of corruption.
Fact is, we had four dead Americans. What difference at this point does it make?
If you've got a business, you didn't build that.
The feeling most people get when they hear a Barack Obama speech, I felt this thrill going up my leg. I don't have that too often.
Steady.
It's time to hear the truth about America's biggest challenges. Ricky Robinson, host of America Off the Rails, will tackle the important issues facing America today as he tries to keep America from coming off the track. Get ready to hear the truth every Monday through Friday starting at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 Central, here on K98Talk.com and the Spark Radio Network.
Oh, welcome to the face. Welcome to the face of the new democracy.
Red Nation Rising brings you Town Hall Radio.
From a single tweet to 3 million a month, our community is a force to be reckoned with on social media.
So don't miss our show, Thursdays, 8 p.m. Eastern on K98 Talk.
Our chat room is our co-host, and you ask the question.
Join us and be heard.
So get ready to sound off on Red Nation Rising Radio. No one else is going to do it for you.
Is it wild, wild whisper?
Are you conservative in a world of liberal?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're not alone. Hey, I'm Daniel Stafford, host of The Stafford Voice, and I'd like to invite you to tune in each Monday, 10 p.m. Eastern, where I'll break down the events of the week, and together we'll learn about how they affect you. So, sit back and get ready for the good, the bad, and the ugly of talk radio right here on K98 Talk.
Welcome back to all my political freaks, geeks, and back alley sneaks. JD and Stacey here on that K98 Talk with that game on. Everybody right now in the sound of my voice, get over that K98Talk.org. Get in that chat room. Say hello to Stacey. Say hello to the best damn listening radio audience. I'm telling you, we should start doing Second City Radio and just let the chat room like throw out the topics. Remember, kids, we're not just here Tuesday nights live, 10 p.m. on that K98 Talk. Thursday nights, we do it again, 9 p.m. for another edition of Game On Live. Saturday morning, 11 a.m., that Bloody Mary's and broadsheets, baby, you'll kill for your mainstream media hangover. Friday nights, 5 p.m., 1360 WNJCAM in that South Jersey, Philadelphia, Northern Delaware. Get over to theflipsideshow.com. Check out that Flipside Show channel. Find it. JD going to be on an episode 4, going to be this weekend or that weekend. Stacey, if they don't have it, what do?
They call their cable company and say, we want the Flipside Show now.
Now. Stop it. And remember, guys, Thursday nights, we want to thank that Radio Red Nation riding, being our lead. And everybody get over to Spreaker.com, hashtag JD and Stacey. That's JDANDSTACEY. Find out all them shenanigans we be getting into. Because remember, kids, remember, our show is very, very easy to explain.
Our shenanigans are cheeky and fun.
Yeah, I mean, his shenanigans are cruel and tragic.
Which makes them not shenanigans at all, really.
Evil shenanigans.
I swear to God, I'll pistol whip the next guy that says shenanigans.
Hey, Farva, what's the name of that restaurant you like with all the goofy shit on the walls and the mozzarella sticks?
You mean shenanigans?
No!
You're talking about shenanigans, right?
Put those away!
So basically, who's Farva and who's like the chief yelling that he's going to pistol whip things and put those away in this whole debate scenario tonight?
Well, you know who was rather tragic and sad?
just one? Who?
No, the most tragic and sad, in my mind, was actually Metric Man.
You know what? For those of you who don't know and happen to miss this one particular show we did, our Black Lives Matter theme song, actually, okay, on my soundboard, it says Lincoln Chafee theme, Sanford and Son. And the reason that it was is because when he announced, his campaign was such junk, we were just like...
Yeah, we had to change that.
Oh, no, wait a minute. I got Lincoln... Oh, no, you know what? I got Lincoln Chafee's right here.
I bring nothing to the table.
Okay.
You were governor of a state the size of a postage stamp.
Oh, this guy's such a snooze. He's such a snooze.
Oh, my God. He was giving Hillary a little bit of heck when I walked away from the TV and woke up my dog.
Listen, well, first of all, Anderson Cooper, who we all decided tonight.
La-di-da-di, we like the party.
Who was just coked out of his shirt. Hey, what do you think? He said, what did he say to, he said to Lincoln Chafee, okay, so they were hitting Uncle Bernie for being a socialist, right? And then Anderson Cooper says to Lincoln Chafee, well, I guess a socialist is the one thing that you haven't been. And I swear to God, I mean, give it to Chafee. I mean, when you watch this nonsense, Uncle Bernie, Mr. Vargas, are you in charge here? Are you in charge here? The colored people, Uncle Bernie believes passionately what he's saying, okay?
Oh.
Lincoln Chafee.
To the point that his hair stands on end.
Lincoln Chafee is just completely...
You know, he's
You're
not
insane.
Right.
No, he is. He's completely out of his marbles. But here's the best part. This is why, and I think this is on our side, why you see Ben Carson, who, by the way, late news before the show, is within 1 point of Trump in some national polls, which in the margin of error is a statistical tie. When you take a look at Carly Fiorina, when you take a look at Ben Carson, and when you take a look at some of the people getting traction, these professional politicians, and that's what you had. That's what you had on this stage tonight was five professional, what you still maybe still have, are five professional politicians. And I mean, he looked with the least self-aware comment I've ever heard. Anderson Cooper tries to hit him for being everything, you know, a Republican, a Democrat, or this or that, an independent. Except a socialist, and with a straight face, Lincoln Chafee goes, I think, what was it, Stacey? What, my core beliefs are the definition of bedrock or something like
granite.
That?
granite.
And
granite,
Anderson
granite.
Cooper said that's pretty squishy granite.
That, oh, but then he sits there and he.
No. When the moderator of the debate on CNN is treating you like a freaking joke when you're on stage, just stop.
No, and this is the same moderator who is basically like,
"You ever seen a grown man naked?"
I mean, this is what you had up here. I mean, you know what it was though with Cooper's questions. I didn't find them probing. I found them caustic. It was almost like they told him, "Hey, man, if you can't cause one of these people to drop kick the other one in the face on national television, you're fired."
Yeah, because they were kind. They actually, which I did not expect, the style was not that different than what Tapper did during the Republican debate. He was pitting people like, "Hey, this guy said this about you." You know,
what do you have to say about that?
This makes no sense to me. But okay.
I think that goes back to just watching this aesthetically, and you have to understand something as well. The Republican candidates, because of the sheer number of them on stage, have to fight for and make their points pretty succinctly. And I think that one, being that you have some non-traditional candidates that are running, and you have the other ones that are just so used to being beaten down by the mainstream media, I think that they are so much better prepared to succinctly make their case. Because when I was watching that debate, and folks, you know, Stacey and I are not lacking on specifics. There was really no there. I mean, we've given you more on the three shows that we do a week about what these candidates have to say than what they said up until about 10 to 10 when we came on the air tonight. There really just was no substance there. And correct me if I'm wrong, Stacey. I mean, I got the feeling that they were not trying to make a sale to the American people. Because when you listen to the SEALs looking to catch fish who were Democratic primary voters in that audience, they almost sound like they were on stage trying to convince each other like five college professors more than make a sale to the American people. I mean, that was my hit. Did you see it the same way?
Yeah, I mean, they weren't trying to sell anything. I mean, we're sitting there relitigating the Iraq war, which to me at this point, guys, it's over.
Listen, the Democratic. All right, if you mention, if you're willing to discuss the Democratic, the Iraq war vote, the Democratic Party, it's religious.
We're on a mission from God.
I mean, it really is. That is, but I mean. Go ahead.
You know, it to me, it's like, okay, let's talk a little bit more about the freaking mess that's sitting over there now. And what are you going to do about it? Because whether or not you would have done it in the early 2000s, that ship has sailed. We did it. How are you going to deal with the repercussions of what we did during the Bush administrations and what we haven't done during the Obama administration? I mean, Hillary's sitting up there saying she's going to tell Putin to be nice. She's going to tell him how he needs to behave, basically.
Right.
You know? And, you know, Bernie Sanders is not Ron Paul, but he was playing him on TV.
You know what? I this is perfect because – so you had Candy Crowley, basically, in the presidential debate, sandbag Mitt Romney in real time with something that she was incorrect about that mentioned about terrorism with the thing in Benghazi, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You had, when you're talking about foreign policy, you all watch the news, the world is literally burning around us. Russia is exerting its dominance in places it's been drooling over for 50 or 60 years. When they got the foreign policy in this debate, Jim Webb is basically a hawk. Uncle Bernie said, "Well, here we got to play with the Russians." And what was that Kankles was sputtering about?
Oh, she was sputtering about a no-fly zone.
Okay. So here you have five people running for president on the Democratic side that were at this debate, right?
Mm-hmm.
Three of them have major differences in their foreign policy, okay? Major differences. I mean, they might as well have been from different parties the way they answered the foreign policy question.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what it was? It was on to the next. Yet every Republican candidate in both series of debates has to spend half of their time answering as to why Donald Trump said something.
Right.
And I think
they were answering, you know, she was having to answer what other people have said about her. I mean, she's had the most public life nationally for the longest period of time.
Who can?
And, you know, they say you did this wrong. They say this is your fault. They say this, they say that. So she was kind of in the Trump position, both on the stage and really kind of getting her rhetoric handed back to her from both sides of the stage.
But, you know, this goes back to, all right, basically, if you want a breakdown of Hillary Clinton tonight, this is it.
Oh, that woman, got a mouth like an outboard motor, all the time.
But it's funny that you draw that analogy, because I made the point the other day that I think it's a fool's errand for any of these candidates that are trying to break through on the Republican side to go toe-to-toe in a pissing match with Donald Trump. Because you cannot win an argument with somebody in real time who will say anything in the moment. No, listen, the sky is blue. I have a Rolls Royce on Mars that gives blowjobs. Well, huge. You know what I'm saying? Okay, you win. Okay, I'll tell you, if I was watching an argument and some guy went, hey, we should have a flat pack, and one guy goes, I got a Rolls Royce on Mars that gives blowjobs, I'd be like, oh, I want to hang out with the Mars blowjob guy.
But hold on.
But this goes to the same point. I think it is brilliant, and I hadn't thought about it till you just said it. She is so much the Democratic Party's Trump, because Anderson Cooper pushed her on Benghazi. And she went, well, Kevin McCarthy and the majority whip and da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Here it is. She fell right back. We still have it. I left this up here for a reason, because, guys, this should live in your memory about how important it is to politics. This is Hillary's ads off Kevin McCarthy's comments from 2 weeks ago.
The Republicans finally admit it.
Republican Kevin McCarthy saying the committee investigating Benghazi and Clinton's emails was created to destroy her candidacy.
Everybody thought Hillary Clinton was unbeatable, right? But we put together a Benghazi special committee. What are her numbers today?
Republicans have spent millions attacking Hillary because she's fighting for everything they oppose, from affordable health care to equal pay. She'll never stop fighting for you, and the Republicans know it.
I'm Hillary Clinton, and I approve this message.
So she takes that exact tact when asked about Benghazi, and you see, and it's a witch hunt, and I don't have to answer, and da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And then after that, Anderson Cooper, to his credit, followed up and went, well, how can you say that this is a partisan witch hunt when there's an FBI criminal investigation that's led to this, the emails, and da-da-da-da. And then she, on a dime, she went, oh, I never said it wasn't important, but no, the FBI is investigating it. You'll see that I have no... I mean, she will say anything in the moment. She really is the Dems' Trump.
Well, they challenged her on that as well. And, I mean, if you could have watched her answering that question and set music to it, she would have been doing like a sidestep, two-step. Are you a progressive? Well, yes, but. No, there is no yes, but. Are you a progressive? According to the bedwetting leftists that we know, you either are or you aren't. And so she prefaces that with, but I also like to get things done, so I know how to compromise and find common ground.
Well, you want to know what?
Ugh.
You want, be, all right,
what
all right,
a horrible answer. She's right. Not a progressive. She's never been a progressive. She's trying to play one on TV, and she's doing a terrible job of it.
We're gonna check with JD and Stacey's special K98 Talk, Homer Simpson, who is currently on the floor of the debate. Homer, do you have an update from the debate?
Boring.
Okay, so. And you know what? All right. So being that these guys aren't going to get any a play, let's take an opportunity to play. O'Malley does have a theme song on the show.
Sing us the song of the Emerald Isle. Oh, tis like the singing of the angels themselves.
I mean, that wasn't much different from what he had to substantively say tonight, was it?
Not particularly. He was giving, because Bernie Sanders, right before I left the room, tried to get out of the whole email debacle.
Oh, I
he
saw
had
that.
A little
I saw
Sanders
that.
Tantrum banging on the podium saying, I've heard enough about the email. I've heard enough about
that.
The email. Let's talk about what's really important, like climate change and inequality, right?
That.
And Hillary looked like she wanted to hug him. And Anderson Cooper goes to Chafee, hey, Lincoln. You've said this is a pretty big deal. And he turns, he goes, absolutely it is.
Well, that, you know.
And I missed Chafee giving Hillary the business because I had to come upstairs and boot up my computer.
No, because I saw that. But you know what, though? He just prattled on. I mean, he just. Like I said, what's his name? He's like, bah, he's like the Reverend Jim from Tech. But Chafee is like creepy professor kind of unhinged. But it's funny you said that because I was trying to think of the politics of it. And I started to say to myself, why is Uncle – either Uncle Bernie was rope-a-doping her like Rocky Balboa said, hey, come on, Hillary, I'm going to take you out in the last round. Let you take a win in your Adrian. And if it wasn't that, then what do you think that the creepy – what do you think that the creepy old man, I'm starting to think that he might have something to hide in his email and that Uncle Bernie might be all like,
I know what boys like, I know what guys want, I know what boys like, boys like, boys like.
Oh, I don't want to talk Metric Man anymore, but honestly, the only one that made like any intellectual sense to me at all about much of anything was Webb, but he looks nuts.
Webb is nuts. Webb got caught with a gun down at the D.C. airport. All right, JD and Stacey have an absolutely important announcement to tell you about tonight's debate coverage.
It's over, Johnny. It's over. Nothing is over. Nothing. You just don't turn it off.
That's right. We watch the things that you don't have to because we put bleach in our eyes and we put acid in our coffee. Coming back in the third segment, we're going to have a little fun. We got dildos and holsters. Something about boobies that I don't even have printed out. Everybody knows what to do. Get over that K98Talk.org chat room. Talk to Stacey. 2.5 minutes. JD and Stacey coming back here on K98 Talk.
Hey everybody, this is Jason, host of According to Me. I'd like to invite you to check out my show. It's a two-hour show that lasts 60 minutes in...
Listen, I hate to interrupt, but one thing I can do is read off a script. Just say, let me be clear a lot. It works.
President Obama, I can handle this. It's a radio promo. I'm not green. I've done this before.
Did someone say green?
Now, Al Gore is here. Listen, I'm just trying to record a radio promo. Do you mind?
Now, do you say good things about me on the show?
No, not at all. But if it makes you feel any better, I rip on Republicans just as much.
The AM radio frequencies give off very high levels of radiation.
Look, my show is on the internet, which you invented. Can I just do my promo?
I got a pen. I can veto that, you know.
I know you got a pen. It's not a law. It's a radio promo. Listen, just listen to my show. Barack Obama and Al Gore hate it, so you're going
to
love it.
Here's an executive order. Don't listen to a show. He doesn't like me. He's racist.
And he doesn't recycle either.
That's it. I'm done. It's According to Me, Wednesdays, 10 p.m. Eastern, right here on K98 Talk.
Wondering why you're up early with us on a Sunday morning making a cocktail? News lately got you drinking? Hungover from the mainstream media by Sunday? We are, and we got you covered.
We sure do. We got your hangover cure for those weekly news blues. So sit back, top off your mimosa, and add some Baileys to that coffee.
Take a match to your copy of the New York Times. Light, fun, and oh yeah, news with booze.
And a lot of laughter.
Welcome to Bloody Marys and Broadsheets. If it's Sunday, it's Bloody Marys and Broadsheets.
We're your cure from your weekly news hangover.
We will never fully understand what we've asked of our military service members or their families, asking them to put themselves in harm's way, to endure it all. But we do understand that it's our turn, our duty, to keep them secure for the rest of their lives. Wounded Warrior Project long-term support programs help our most severely ill or injured veterans live independently, at no cost, for life, so that they might stand at ease. Join us at findwwp.org.
K98 Talk is expanding its lineup for 2015. This means we are expanding our advertising base. Whether you're a startup trying to push through to the next level, or an established business trying to supplement your advertising budget, web-based advertising is a solid investment. Thanks to Talk's newest partnership with TuneIn Radio and instant access to our sister station, K98 FM, we give you worldwide access at a reasonable cost. Interested parties should email us at sales@k98fm.com.
Welcome back, everybody. JD and Stacey here on that K98 Talk. Everybody in the sound of my voice, you know what to do. K98talk.org chat room. Stacey, great audience and radio. Tuesday 10, Thursday 9, Sunday 11. WWNJC 1360 AM in that Jersey, Philly, and Northern Delaware, baby. Michael Loftus, Flipside Show, episode 4, theflipsideshow.com. Channel finder, cable company don't carry it. What happens?
You call your cable company and you say, we want that Michael Loftus Flipside Show now.
And if you're enjoying this Japanese game show on As It Meets Political Talk Meets Metallica, baby, you get over to Spreaker.com, you hashtag JD and Stacey, JDANDYSTACEY, and what do they do, baby?
They download everything we talked about before.
Oh, and they tell 5 people about it.
Oh, yeah, send the link to your friends, your family, even people who don't like you.
Write it on bathroom walls.
You can just write the JD part of JD and Stacey on bathroom walls. Leave me out of it.
Okay, terrific.
Okay, terrific.
Now you always stop in the, you know, in the restrooms on the side of the road on like a long road trip, and you just, you know, you've been zoning out in the car, enjoying your music. You're still wrapping your head around it. You walk into the bathroom, and it's just a whole bunch of,
hey, where are the white women at?
And you're like, all right, I'm gonna go piss outside.
Oh dear Lord.
Okay, before we get into dildos and boobies.
Oh my God. I have to quote this article. I have to pull it up.
Before you do that, there were 2 things left over that didn't make it into the other segment that I thought were quite as funny. So, for those of you who are just joining us, Uncle Bernie, feel the burn. Remember, Bernie Sanders.
Oh, Mr. Vargas, are you in charge here? Are you in charge? The colored people are yelling. Ha, ha, ha.
He now has a new JD and Stacey theme song.
Boom, boom, boom. My body,
can call me Speedo, but my real name is Mister.
All right, so we got Mr. Speedo over here. So now, Uncle Speedo, did you see what his campaign dropped? And this is hysterical since you and I got to watch the debate before we came on. Campaign manager, Bernie using debate to connect with black voters. Did you see this?
No.
Oh, Bernie Sanders just going all up into the black community being like,
we're on a mission from God.
So, Bernie Sanders will use the first Democratic debate to reintroduce himself to black voters. I want you to think about this. I would like to know how much reintroducing a man who looks like Christopher Lloyd needs to the black community. Something tells me that once you see Uncle Bernie, you know who Uncle Bernie is. Quote, I think we're going to talk about issues of importance to the black community, unquote, said Jeff.
Like climate change.
Oh, yeah. I think we're going to talk about criminal justice reform. I think we're going to talk about dealing with systemic racism. I think we're going to talk about many of the economic issues that are important to African American voters. One of his first answers were, you have never been in Congress. To what the hell is this?
Well, this was after the half an hour fanfare, Sheryl Crow murdering the freaking national anthem, flag waving in the background nonsense that went on for the first 30 minutes of this debacle.
But it wasn't. There's such zombies. I mean, did you, like, they called Sheryl Crow out? I mean, the place just got.
If you just screenshot it, dude, if it was, you know, if there had been a TV show called Golden Guys, it would have been like The Reunion. I'm just looking at the stage going,
oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God.
What?
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Whatever the you're thinking, don't you dare
no,
say
it. No, this isn't that bad. The guys running for president, basically Hillary is Estelle Getty.
Exactly. Martin O'Malley could be Stan.
Oh, what do I have anything on here? But I don't think I have anything on here for old people. We got to find something
got to get that theme song when we're talking about the Dem presidential candidates.
Oh, wait, breaking news. Hold on a second. Anderson Cooper tried to make some headlines here with the last question to Hillary in the debate. Hold on.
You're a liar! You know something that you're not telling us, you slimy scumbag liar!
However, Hillary did not respond.
No.
All right, so going into this, what would be affectionately called where I come from, a pig F. Going into this pig F, most U.S. voters not aware of Democratic debate. This is a Reuters Ipsos poll. Polled from October.
That's because they don't have their own reality TV star.
That 57% of registered voters were not aware of the debate between the five candidates to be held at the Wynn Hotel in Las Vegas.
Okay, terrific.
Oh, my God.
That's
okay.
Kind of a good thing, isn't it?
So, being that Stacey and I are now governed by the FCC on Fridays, which we're trying to make the show, we're trying to keep the show what it is without getting kicked off of radio. So, there is a movement that, there's an event.
On a campus in Texas.
Right. It's sponsored by the Students for Concealed Carry. They support the
student
No. Right.
It's opposing the Students for Concealed Carry. The Students for Concealed Carry say they have a right to protest this way.
Right. Oh, okay, I see it quick. So, what
the anti-gunners.
Doing is, they're basically calling this...
The Gun Sense Loons. Not Glocks.
Right.
Okay. Terrific.
Why don't you give the kids a little savor of slavery?
When you go to Austin, Texas, and you go to a group called Students for Concealed Carry, what they do to protest their inability to carry on campus is they wear empty holsters.
Right.
So I'm pretty sure because that one word rhymed with Glock. The anti-gunners, gun sense folks, decided they were going to violate the campus's decency policy by carrying dildos sticking out of their backpacks.
Of course they were.
What does that have to do with guns?
I don't know. But in such a surprising twist, using a dildo as a defensive weapon could classify it as a club, which under Texas law is illegal to carry in public.
It
constitutes
yes.
a felony if carried in campus buildings. I remember, when I was in college, do not threaten
to whack anybody with that dildo.
Let me tell you something. When JD was in college and your date broke out the dildo, it was all about
giggity, 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 let's have sex.
I know, but I'm like watching this hashtag go yesterday, and I'm like, other than the word beep, 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 rhyming with Glock, what in the world does one have to do with the other? You know,
Male rooster.
I mean, I'm sitting here going, I'm an advocate of campus carry. I think Dana Lesh has spoken on it the best. You know, sorry you didn't raise your kids to be responsible and you don't think they can be responsible gun owners. But you can stop screeching that animal in my ear right now. Stop.
Okay, and, terrific.
But if you want to protest concealed carry on campus, there's probably a better way to do it than with a big pink dildo sticking out of your backpack.
Well, yeah, I would hope so. All right, I think how much? Let's see what the clock says here. Clock is telling 2 minutes 15 seconds. Something about wet socks full of sand that look like boobies or boobies that look like.
No, actually, they started a hashtag today, which was meant to support victims of breast cancer. For those of you who don't know, it's Breast Cancer Awareness Month for the entire month of October. One of them is to support women who have undergone radical surgery, and it's called No Bra Day. So there were pictures of survivors and a lot of messaging stories early, and then as Twitter normally is, the hashtag goes completely awry. And the next thing you know, we're showering all of these women who have had radical surgery with picture of actual boobs, and then we move to moobs, and then we move to the worst looking boobs you've ever seen. And I'm just sitting there scrolling through this hashtag going, oh, my God. Oh, my God. How do you go from something to support breast cancer awareness to this? And then all these Hollywood stars are taking pictures of themselves or someone is taking pictures of them celebrating No Bra Day. And the only good news for me that came out of this horrible hashtag on Twitter is theirs are subject to gravity too.
Oh, you know what? You know what?
Like,
the world.
What you're seeing in the movies, boys, is totally airbrushed.
It has been. It has been such. It has been such of. All right. This describes the last 24 hours right here.
It's over, Johnny. It's over. Nothing is over. Nothing.
Oh, it's
you just
so
don't turn it off.
And let me tell you why. Playboy has decided to, within the last 24 hours, just print the articles and no longer print naked women. Something that had to do with boobies and my own radio show made me sick and want to vomit in my mouth. And now college kids on campuses find dildos and don't know what to do with them. I think the only thing left to say is...
Okay, terrific.
We want to thank everybody.
You can't use them as a club. That's illegal.
Oh, my God. Well, then JD's must be illegal in 50 states, baby. We want to thank everybody for joining JD and Stacey tonight on that K98 Talk. Stacey, girl, you got them keys?
I got them keys, and I'm so tired.
Let's get the hell out of here. Tell the nice kids what you're doing the next few hours.
The next few hours, I'm going to be looking at the inside of my eyelids.
Very nice. Tonight's show, everybody, was dedicated to a very special man, special friend of the show that Stacey and I had the great privilege to call Uncle Michael. Mike Futterman unexpectedly left us, but he's never going to leave us. Ride with the angel seat, Prince. JD will see everybody Thursday night.
I'm looking for you, you Occupy freaks, with your glitter bombs. Bring it on! Bring on the glitter. Everything has changed. Everything has changed in the last few years. Conservatives used to take it, and we're not taking it anymore.
When our water heater broke down last month, it was a nightmare. It took 5 hours for the plumber to show up, and he charged us a couple of $100 just to come out. Then it cost another $1,800 to put in the new water heater. By the time it was all said and done, I felt like I'd been taken. But what else could I do?
The smartest thing you can do is get a home warranty from American Residential Warranty. Their home warranties pay to repair or replace all your major appliances when they break. And they will break. And at the worst possible time, call American Residential Warranty right now for free information on home warranties starting at just pennies a day. Don't wait for your refrigerator to stop running or your ceiling fans to stop turning. Call American Residential Warranty right now. Ask how you can save up to 50% on washer and dryer coverage. Just call 1-800-513-6154. That's 1-800-513-6154. Again, 1-800-513-6154. Call now.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Giggity, 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 let's have sex.